Moment in time, isn't it? And I want to welcome you to this morning, for this is your moment in time. Your moment in time to express the real you, to be in full expression. Does that excite you?
Yes.
What?
Yes.
Yeah, because this is the only moment we have. It's kind of like what we're talking about today. It's the blessings of forgiveness. And I love that song that he sung just a moment ago, because it is powerful. But I want to start off with one thought from that song, that we often go to the impossible. But it's only impossible until we do it. Because the impossible is the doorway to transformation. If transformation was easy, would we even notice if we did it? Just something to contemplate for a moment. But today's talk is about the blessings of forgiveness. And there's actually two things going on there. The blessings, what are the blessings of forgiveness? And forgiveness itself. But I want to start off with a couple of questions. And it's simply this. Will you forgive me? Can you forgive me? Will you forgive others? Can you forgive others? Can you forgive yourself? And will you forgive yourself? Those are some powerful questions to contemplate. Because can we? Of course we can. But will we is another thing. And we know through all the things we already shared this morning, even the idea of namaste, I honor that place within you as you honor it within me. We're not separate. We are really one. So as I forgive you, I begin the process of forgiving myself. And also the other way around. There's great power in that. And the blessings are this. When we begin to forgive, and actually maybe step over a little further and forgive, what begins to happen? What falls away? Anger, resentment, just kind of falls away. Resistance to life. All these different things that we use as blocks to prevent us from feeling the true essence of our own love. Wow, what a thing to think about, forgiveness. See, forgiveness is really, it's not a selfish act, but then again it is. Because when we forgive ourselves and when we forgive others, it's really about allowing ourselves to be free. That's freedom. Freedom. Forgiveness is about allowing the freedom to be in the present moment without the past coming and controlling what we decide, what we feel in any moment. True forgiveness is letting go of anything that prevents us. It's our choice that we keep it there, by the way. But prevents us from living in full expression in this moment, right here, right now. And as we forgive, what happens? All that resistance does what? Just kind of floats away, doesn't it? Now, when we're in the middle of something and we have a lot of resentment, it sure doesn't feel that way, does it? What can be the blessings of me forgiving that person or forgiving myself? I did so many wrongs all my life. Well, that could be true. But what does forgiveness do for us? It doesn't change what we did, but it changes how we accept ourselves in this moment. And this is the moment of power within us. This is where we live in our spirit. This is where we have the ability to let go of anything that doesn't allow us to be ourselves and to grow a new moment, a new future, a new way of seeing things, a new way of participating in life itself. But sometimes that's frightening, isn't it? We bite our fingernails and we do all these things and we go, but I don't know what I would do. I don't know what I would do if I let go of all that stuff. Who would I be? Good question. Good question. Who would you like to be? Who do you think you could be? Now, we talk a lot about visualization and thinking about and contemplating our beingness and all these things. And we see in the world around us these people that say, well, if they were just kinder. Well, there's a lesson for me. What if I were kinder? Well, if they would just treat me better. Well, what if I treated them better? You know, we have this great world around us that is really a reflection of what's going on inside of us. And we see it every single day. But do we notice? Do we notice what's really going on in our world and realize that we're participating in it and we're connected with it all the time? Can we forgive ourselves for creating maybe an experience inside of us that we don't want to have? I'm not saying it's easy, but at the same time, I'm saying it is. But it also is the doorway to freedom. Forgiveness is the doorway to freedom. It's the doorway to transformation. It's the doorway to step into our power. It's the doorway to understanding the presence of God, love, whatever you want to call all this stuff. It's the doorway there. And you know, we're standing in the doorway all the time. We have the option to do so. And it's not condoning anybody's behavior for what they did. Oh my gosh, no. What it is condoning is our ability to step into our power and let the past be the past. And moving all ourselves into this present moment and learn to live in our fullest expression, whatever that might be for us. Yes, it may seem impossible. It may even be something we find really difficult because something horrendous may have been done to us. I'm not saying those things don't happen. I know they do. We can see it in our world. But what I am talking about is the blessings that forgiveness offers. It allows us to be our most powerful self this moment, to change our life, to change our experience, to become those dreams that we dreamed about and that we put out there in our universe for so long that says, okay, I finally accept my dream. I'm here now. I'm not holding myself back. Because when we do that, then we get to see the moment as a precious new moment with new eyes. Because what I've mentioned before, and I'm going to say it again because it's really something I remind myself often about, is the spiritual journey, or even the journey to forgiveness, is not for the faint of heart. It's for the full of heart. For it requires a full heart to feel the love that we can give to our world and to our life and step into our power to be what we're here to be. Think about that. It requires a full heart. Because if we're giving love away, what happens in return? As we give, so shall we receive. We've heard that before, right? So if we're giving love away, it's having enough trust and faith within our own being that we're being filled up with the same love we're giving away. That it's an endless supply. Forgiveness is that doorway to know our endless supply. It has nothing to do with what we may have perceived as being wronged for us. I know those experiences are real, and they hurt sometimes. And sometimes we've done them to others, and we don't even know we've done them, but they harbor that within them. But what I am saying is, the blessings that forgiveness offers all of us, as we begin to give and forgive others, and we forgive ourselves, that we step into a power that transforms, first of all, our personal world, and then the world around us. But it does take courage. And that comes from that love that we hold inside of us, that full heart. Because I know it takes strength to step out and be who we are and who we want to be, because we know the people that we were with yesterday may not like us changing. They may even feel offended. But if we do it from the place of forgiveness and the grace within our own heart, then in time, and generally a relatively short time, everything begins to move. Everything begins to shift. We've been told that over and over and over. Forgiveness, forgiveness, forgiveness. And we dabble with it and we play with it, and that's fine. We can do all that. But when we forgive, we know we have because we're moved to be in our power. But however we can get there, if it's by practicing just on the surface, start. Just start. Just start. Because we resist starting, don't we? Because we know, and I know, one of our greatest fears that we carry with us in our society today is the fact, if I were to be different, who would I be? What would my life be like? So I'm suggesting if we want to do that, start speculating. What would it be like? If you were to forgive yourself for anything you've done in the past, even a moment ago, even the good stuff, because it's not about making something right or wrong. It's about allowing yourself to be free in this moment to be who you choose to be. So who would you choose to be? If you were free from all that stuff, who would you be? Take some time to contemplate that stuff. Let all the other stuff go. Because forgiveness promotes freedom. Now I want to talk about the other word for the title of the talk. Blessings of freedom. What is a blessing? A blessing generally is something that promotes what? Our wholeness, our goodness. It promotes quality of life or love. So if we are really forgiving, we know we're promoting all that for us. And we begin to feel that. We begin to get the visceral feeling in our body and these emotions that begin to move us to a new place. That's transformation. Now for some of us, and I know myself for a long time, transformation scared me. Because I didn't understand it. I thought transformation meant I had to give up myself. But that's not what transformation is. Transformation is revealing who you really are and letting the real you out into your full expression in a way that's authentic and real for each of us. And that transforms every connection we have in our world, and it brings a camaraderie within all the different aspects of ourself that works together, that brings forth a powerful spirit of our own being. That's what transformation does. It brings a power to the surface that we no longer hide to the side, and we bring it forth and say, yes. Because as we transform, we move and change, not just us. Because after all, what, we're connected, right? We understand that. But do we really understand that? Some years ago, I was introduced to a work. It's a form of Hawaiian healing treatment. And many of us heard about it. It's a Ho'oponopono. I may have pronounced it incorrectly, but it's somewhere along that lines. And it's really about forgiveness. But more than that, it's about taking responsibility for everything in our experience, in our world. And that's a hard one for many. Because we keep thinking that the outside is separate from us. And it's okay that we do that. But when we begin to get a glimpse, just a small glimpse, of that all this outside is truly within us, and the way to allow it to serve us is to let go and forgive. Forgive all the disturbances it may have brought up. But then we get the argument, well, but what about these people over here? Forgive them too. But forgive yourself for having that experience. I know it sounds very strange and weird because we're not used to having that understanding. But what I am saying here is as we learn to forgive, first ourselves and then our world around us, it's not condoning the behavior, it's forgiving and letting it go and knowing that it was all here to serve us. Everything that we attract into our world, the things we began to learn even from the movie The Secret, was everything that we emanate out from us and our resonance we attract into our world. So if it's here, we're participating in it. And if we don't like it, let's forgive ourselves and let it go. I'm reminded by a short story in the Christian Bible where Peter asked Jesus, "How much should I forgive?" And Peter says, 7 times? And Jesus answered, 70 times 7. Because it isn't really about how many times you forgive. It's simply, keep forgiving. Keep forgiving. Because it's a process of life. It's a way of looking at our world and realizing, wow, I brought this into my moment. Now I can let it go and embrace something new. Forgiveness. That's a big one for a lot of us, isn't it? Anybody here besides me ever have challenges with forgiveness? Yeah, see, I'm not the only one. Ah, But I will share this with you. It is a key to transformation. So if you want to be cautious about anything, just realize if you start forgiving, you're going to change. And your world will change around you. But I will share this. You will be gifted beyond measure with things that you can experience, but more than anything, you will be gifted with your own power to be fully yourself in full expression. And we've let go in the process of what? Fear. We've let go of what other things? Resentment. Jealousy. We've let go of all these things that we often say are negative. But could you imagine, just imagine for a moment, what your life could be like if all that was gone? Think about that. If all that was gone. I'm not saying you have to let it go. That's up to you. But if it was all gone, there was no jealousy. There was no fear. There was no resentment. What would you do differently? Ah, you might have to learn to actually feel your own love. And that's deep in our soul, isn't it? It's deep in our soul. Forgiveness is all about ourselves and how we interact and become one with our universe. Now, some may say that's selfish. I would say it's important. That we understand that we're connected to all things. And our greatest power that we have is not in changing our outer world, but in transforming ourselves, which in turn transforms our outer world. There's great power in our world, in our universe, and it all starts with ourselves. For we have an immense ability to be fully present in any moment with all that we are. And anything that doesn't fit what we want to experience, we can let go of through the process of forgiving. I'm going to share one more thing and then I'm going to wrap up here for a moment. It's simply this. If I have a closed heart and I want to give from my heart, what do? I give, but my fist is closed, isn't it? How well do you think that'll be received? But if I have an open heart, and I open it and I give. My hand is open. And I can give much. But I have to open. So as we close this morning, let's think about that we do deserve our own forgiveness. And we do deserve forgiveness of all. Thank you. Thank you.